Hiraeth, a word in Welsh for which there is no English equivalent. It describes the heartsick longing that grips a person in exile from their homeland, cut off from family, culture, and all that defines them. The longing may be emotional, but manifests itself physically too. It is quite possible for a sufferer to sicken and to die. Hiraeth.
I'm not in charge here. She should be out back.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
So, continental breakfast. It's from 6 till 8 every morning. And if you need a wake-up call, ask me the night before. Oh, do you need help with your bag?
No, thank you. I'm okay.
Okay.
I was wondering, how old are you? I'm sorry. I wasn't meaning to be rude or anything. It just seemed like pretty young to be running this place.
Well, I am young, but this business has been in my life since I was born, and my parents run this place most of the year.
Yeah.
And right now they're on vacation, so are you all right?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm fine.
So I thought I could take care of it myself.
Okay, fair enough, I guess, yeah.
Okay, so here's your room.
Okay.
If you need anything, just call.
Alright, thanks.
Have a nice day.
Thank you. I lost my cell phone, so I was wondering if I could borrow yours.
Yeah, sure, okay, it was here a moment ago. Well, there's a payphone in town, so you can probably use that.
Alright.
Oh, by the way, P is pence, not pounds. You wouldn't want you spending $50 on a phone call.
Thanks.
No problem.
Hello? Hi, it's David. Yeah, how's it going? Good. Yeah, so I was wondering if, you wanted to come over for lunch or something tomorrow. I have to talk to you about something, yeah. Okay. Cool. Okay, good. Bye.
Gave yourself away.
Why do you collect all those articles about disappearances?
I'm looking for a monster.
Okay.
I'm serious. There's a monster that lives in the mist, eats people.
Okay, and what exactly are you going to do about it?
I'm going to find the monster, and I'll be the catcher.
Well, when you get back, give my manuscript a read. Hey, did you get a chance to read my book yet?
I did. It was pretty interesting. I liked it. It was good. But I didn't quite understand the part where she travels through time to save her sister, but then the plot gets dropped halfway through.
That sounds really stupid.
Excuse me?
Why would someone travel back in time to save their sister and then forget about them?
'Cause
this thing happens and he has to stop it. Well, you should read the book, because it's really exciting.
Thanks for the offer, but that sounds like a waste of both my time and yours.
You have time to find a monster who lives in the mist?
Yes, I do. You shouldn't talk about loss if you don't know anything about it. Frankly, I think you should stick to that travel launch book.
It was good. I liked it. Don't worry about it. It was good.
Thanks for coming by.
Of course. David, I'm glad you called. I had no idea you were back.
It's David now. But do you remember when we were around 7 or 8, we climbed this mountain?
Sure I do. We got really lost. And your dad was furious.
Well, do you remember a tree?
It was a mountain. I remember lots of trees.
It wasn't just any tree. The tree was maybe the size of this patio, and it twisted all the way to the top.
I don't remember anything like that.
Well, I have dreams about it, a lot. And I need to find it.
You flew across an ocean to find a tree?
If you look at it like that, then yes. But it's like this thing's calling to me.
I don't mean to trivialize this. I mean, it's obviously important to you, but Daffod, it hurts that the only reason you called me here was because of a tree.
The reason I called you here is because I want you to come with me.
Absolutely.
Trees are not the same. Some record human histories, whispering stories of love and loss each time the wind teases their limbs. Ancient stories tell of trees that bear witness to a dozen lifetimes of suffering, each lifetime passing like a storm. Day by month, by year, they steal away our sorrow until we become light enough for the world to absorb us. A monstrous creature, the Afank, is said to prey upon anyone foolish enough to taunt it. A long time ago, it was rendered helpless by a maiden who let it sleep upon her lap. While it slept, her true love bound the creature in chains. Waking suddenly, the Afank was enraged. Its thrashing crushed the maiden in whose lap it lay. Finally, it loped off into the mist and disappeared.
location. This could be a really great setting for when the vampires time travel. Like, they go back to an ancient village and mess around with its history.
How's the travelogue coming?
It's going great, just great. I found an ice cream parlor in town. They have amazing gelato.
Gelato?
I would never have thought so, but it's the best gelato in Wales.
Okay. You good till the end of the week?
Sure. I'm going to a castle tomorrow.
Sounds good. Bye.
Bye.
And trickles when you listen closely enough. I'd almost call it breathing. I like being held in its breath. Guests mostly miss things like that. So many of them are so focused on the going, they forget the where. The lights reflect off the straps of their backpacks, filing through one after the other. I'd forgotten the Earth could still do this. The thing where it spins. Day turns to night, and another body occupies the bed over there. If you've been here longer than you ought to, you can't help but wonder if you're actually existing. Or just drifting through a well-written account of your life. Like every detail's been thought out with endless care, and you're not entirely sure why. always been people in and out of the walls. Their stays just shortened and their surnames started to vary. They still talk the same, though urban legends have replaced folk tales in the lips of the travelers. But still, the earth hurtles on at breakneck speed, but tethered here, time seems to pay no attention to it.